In today's video, we're going to build a simple AR game using Reality Composer. I'm going to open up the Reality Composer app, create a new project. Because we're building a game on top of the floor, we're going to choose the horizontal plane as the anchor. And if you're not familiar with the software and how to navigate it, you can check out my first video, which I'll link up on the top right and also on the description. And now I'm going to import the 3D models that we need. So first I'm going to get the cans in. That looks great, the cans are ready. Next, I'm going to import the toy. And finally, I'm going to bring in the tennis ball. We want to add physics to these objects so that it would behave realistically when colliding with other objects. So for that, I'm going to select each object. So first the tennis ball. Go to the Inspector tab and click on Participates under the Physics section. I'm also going to set the motion type to dynamic, and I can choose different materials to simulate different behaviors, also collision shapes. And now we can start adding in the behaviors. So behaviors is essentially animations or movements or actions in the scene. For example, you could use preset behaviors like tap and flip, which flips an object when you click on it. And you can also start proximity and juggle. So when the object is close to when the camera is close to the object would jiggle. We're just going to create a custom scene. The first behavior we're going to create, we'll call it ball throw. And this will be the behavior of throwing the ball when you tap on it. And each behavior comes with a trigger and an action sequence. A trigger is what starts the behavior, and an action sequence is a set of actions that happens after the trigger is triggered. So there are various kinds of triggers you can choose, and because we want to throw the ball when we touch it, we're going to click the tap trigger for this action. And the affected objects would be the ball, because that is what we want to detect the tap on. And for the action sequence, we want to add a force when we tap on the ball. For that, we're going to choose add force, which applies an impulse force to the object, and we're going to choose the angle by dragging and drop. Now when I tap on the ball, that's great. So the second behavior we're going to add now is that of the obstacle moving around the cans. So for that, I'm going to create again a custom behavior. Here we want to trigger the enemy movement right when the scene starts. So we're going to choose scene start as the trigger. And for the action, we're going to choose orbit. So the orbit action creates an orbit for the object to move around with respect to a center. So we're going to click orbit, and the affected object would be the toy. We're going to choose this can as the center of the orbit. Click done. And now let's again test this out. As you can see, it's rotating around, but it only goes through one revolution and it's not facing towards the direction it's moving at. So we're going to fix that by going to the orbit action and clicking align to path, and also clicking this icon so that the action would loop forever. So now we've got the fundamental actions of the game set. We need to add one more thing, which is the game ending behavior. And for the game ending behavior, we want the game to end when the ball hits the toy. So as the trigger, we're going to choose collide as a trigger. So the collide trigger detects when two objects collide with each other. So I'm going to click on collide, and the affected object would be the ball collides with, we're going to choose the toy. So when the game ends, first what we want to do is create a pop-up text showing the user that the game ended. Then after a while, we want to bring up a reset button. So we need to bring in a text. That looks great. Now I'm also going to create the reset button, which we'll just use a sphere. And I'm going to add another text. And change the text to reset. I'm also going to add in a different color for the reset button. I'm going to go to the inspector and choose material color. I'm going to choose red. And we only want these game over objects to appear at the end of the game, not at the beginning of the game. So what we need to do is add another behavior. We're going to name it scene start. And in the scene start behavior, we want to hide all these game ending objects when the scene starts. So we're going to click the trigger as scene start and the action as hide. So as the affected objects, I'm going to click on the sphere, the text, both of the text, and click done. So now let's go back to the game ending behavior. So first thing I'm going to do is click on the show action and choose the game over text as the affected object. And then I want to wait for a while. I'm going to click the wait action. So this first shows the game over text, then waits for 1 second. And after this, the next action I want to add is that of bringing up the reset game button. So here I'm going to click show again. And this time I'm going to select two objects, which is the sphere and the reset game text. I also forgot one thing. We also need to hide the game over text before bringing up the reset game button. So I'm going to click another hide action right after the wait. Let's test this out and see if this works. So the game is playing. If I hit the toy button, you can see the game over text popped and next the reset game. And the final thing we need to do now is to create the game reset behavior. For that, we're going to create a new behavior. And over here, all we want to do is reset the game when the user taps on the reset button, which is a sphere. So for that, we're going to use the tap trigger and choose the sphere as the affected object. For the action sequence, there's no default reset game button, but we're going to choose the change scene action and select the current scene as the affected object. And what happens here is that when the user taps on the sphere button, the change scene action would trigger the same scene to start again, which is essentially like restarting the game with its initial settings. Now if I tap on the ball and it hits the toy like that, game over and reset game. Now if I click the reset game button, you can see the ball resets its position. And that's it. Hope you enjoyed it. And for more tutorials like this, do subscribe to my channel. And next week, I've got something special planned for you. See you then.